Hello and welcome back to Maypole Farms. It is now early December and as you can see it is snowing. We're having a white one, but that's not stopping us. We still have a lot of work to do. Now, me and my worker, we stayed out late last night trying to get these meadows ploughed up. Work had a little bit of an issue doing the corners, but that's absolutely fine. And when we come to plant that, I believe that our new John Deere seeder is a combi one, so that'll cultivate that at the same time. So that shouldn't be a problem really, that'll turn in. But our worker has got to get out there and do some stone picking for us today. So that's what we're going to do to start with. We're going to get them set up in the John Deere, which is just here. Already got the John Deere and the stone picker set up. We want to get this done so we're not paying for the leasing for it anymore, because we're paying for a long-term lease at the minute. We don't want to be doing that for too long. But you don't make a lot of money for these stones. So they are off and they're going at speed. They're not hanging around today. So I'm going to have to be on the ball, because we'll get them in the sheep's meadow straight after. But our first job is going to be to get some lime down on the two large meadows. So for that, we're going to need to get rid of that. We're going to need to head over to the store and get ourselves a lime spreader, because we don't actually own one. Our solid fertilizer spreader doesn't do lime, unfortunately. So we need to go and lease one for that. And because we've got all the meadows to do, we're going to get quite a big one. That's the plan anyway. We haven't been out in winter. We have been out in winter. I don't think we've been out in snow. So, it could settle for us. The scale at the top doesn't give us no sunshine, no break in it. So it could start to lay eventually. So I think to keep costs down to start with, we're going to go with the bronze, 8,000 litre capacity. We're going to need to fill this up a few times. I think we have about 20,000 litres on the farm. So I'm going to fill this up before we go. And hopefully that'll be enough to see us through for quite a bit. We may have to come back and do some more, but we are going to lease it. This is probably the cheaper option. Available for leasing, I think, of this sort of size. So that's where we're going with that. It's going to cost us $1,200. In anticipation for needing a few extras, I've brought a few extras. So even if we don't have to come back and get them, we can come and attach. We can come and collect. I'm struggling with my words already today. Come back and collect. So I shall fill this up. Trying to spin my head round as well the wrong way, and we'll head back down to the farm. Our worker is getting through that nicely. Doing a really good job. Just weaving through with the brightness. I think the lime, if I remember rightly, is stored round the back of the shed in front. Terrible English today, absolutely terrible. Just get ready for a lot of stumbling over words, people, because it's not coming out right from the get-go. The one on the right-hand side there, that's got our lime in. So, I think we're going to get through it all. I think we're going to need more. You think we've got these two and them two. I think some of them were done quite recently, so open that up. I was saying this one doesn't need any. All good for lime apparently. Perfect pH. So perhaps I'm not going to need all this. Let's have a little look at our map. Well, we've got some varying levels of pH throughout. So I think we need to still go over it. We'll see. I mean, if this is pointless, then we'll cut it out. I just know that I am about to drive all the way around this field just to check. Well, I drove around both meadows and apparently neither of them need any lime at all. So let's see about this grass meadow. So we haven't limed these in a long time. And I would have thought they wanted a little bit. Even looking at the chart, the overhead map, I thought they would have wanted some. I know they're just grass, but that was the whole point in us digging them up, is because they looked like they wanted a bit more pH. And yeah, we've created all this extra work. We've brought extra machinery, leased a lot of machinery to do this. Apparently, the science is saying they're good. So I've got myself another 10,000 litres of lime to put in storage, and a Bruns to return. So I'm back from dropping the spreader off. Since we returned it within 30 minutes, they were kind and they've given us back £600 out of the 1,200 that we spent on the lease. Our worker has now finished in that meadow, and if I come out far enough, you can see just off in the distance, they have started work over in the sheep's meadow. So, I think the only thing that's really for us to do is sell. Now we can sell silage, or we can sell some honey and eggs. Go with the silage, we've got a lot of silage. We'll let our honey and eggs stock up a little bit. The cereal factory is actually paying 3,000 per 1,000 litres for honey at the minute, and we do have over 6,000 litres of honey, so about 19 grand's worth of honey just sitting around, so that is always there, ticking over, building up. But what we'll do, we'll get the rest of, well, I say the rest of this 200,000 litres. I think even if we sold 100,000 litres, that would be pretty good. Just to be doing something. It sounds silly, I guess, just to be doing something for the sake of doing something, but our worker's out, and we can do this. It's something that we would be doing anyway. Yeah, I could do a couple of loads and then just see what we've got going contract-wise. I may do that. We'll do a couple of these, because this is our way of making money now. This makes better money for us than going out contracting. We can't sow our grass now. It's too late in the year, so we do have to wait. I think March? Yeah, I think March is when we can sow our grass again. So rest of December, January, February, probably rest through that. I'll make sure that the cows are well stocked. We'll top up some hay and some silage. Perhaps I'll top up some silage out of this one today. There'll be plenty there. That robot has got loads in. And even if the feeder did run out in 2 months, there's about 300,000 litres of hay in the actual feed trough as well, so they are not going hungry. But we'll have to keep an eye on it, because I think probably end of spring, early summer, I think we have some more cows, some more calves arriving, so that just means more milk as well, which is great, because that milk made us a lot of money. Now, no, I won't. I was going to then tell you something about the other series, but I won't, because that's quite a way ahead, and I don't want to spoil it. Not spoil it. We'll just talk about Maypole. A couple more loads in here, and this will be done. We are like the silage kings of Maypole. It's got so much of it. It's great. It's just money sitting there. Maybe we could invest in a conveyor. Maybe that would be an easier way of filling. just park the trailer up and pull one of the conveyor belts or something like that. So it feeds it in. And there's plenty of them about now. It's not nothing, it's not something I've ever really done a lot of. The conveyors, even back in 15 and 17 when it was sort of the way of making money with the silage was setting up conveyor belts. I just always preferred to jump in a telehandler and just do it the proper way. Never been in that desperate of a rush with my gameplay that I need to pump it all through or leave it running forever, selling. Let's go and sell this one though, and we'll see what sort of money we get for it. A couple of quid, that'd be nice. I forget how much it holds. 35,200 litres, which is quite a bit. And our lovely Deutz isn't really going to have any issue with this. It's 190 horsepower. This should be able to pull us more milk as well when it comes to selling milk. I know it's only like an extra, probably 700-800 litres, but you know, over the course of 3 or 4 trips, that's more milk and less trips to do, so it's all feasible, it's all viable. Now the good thing about the winter months is we can see through the trees a bit better. When we come down here, let's get out of your way, sir. He's tooting at me. Well, I did my best. But this silage is getting wet. Perhaps that's why we should sell all the silage, because it's sitting there open. That needs to be undercover. Now, with how the placeables work, I may be able to put a cover over that. Might do that. Another way of sort of making the farm our own, if I can find some shelters that just about fit over them nicely. Place them in, keep our silage dry when it's open. Could be cool. Normally though, you'd want to put the shelter, then put the clamp in after, rather than the other way around. But I can have a little look. Do that one evening when we're not farming. Now we got 19,112 last time, so not sure what the price is at. I never really look, because you know, this is where I sell it. We take what they give us and they normally give us a good price. $18,771. Like I say, a good price. I'm more than happy with that. So maybe do a couple of these, and I might look into that honey. The honey could be interesting. It's a big old bumper in it of finances, and that'll get us on the road to another plot of land and setting up some greenhouses and stuff like that. This is our second load going for sale today, and before I left I did stick 16,000 litres of silage into the robot feeder to keep that topped up. That means the clamp now has 124,000 litres in it. It's crazy how much we have. Bearing in mind we've still got nearly 500,000 in the small clamp. We are silaged up. So this should go for about the same. Our worker has let us know that they finished stone picking, so when we get back we'll jump in the John Deere and we'll empty that and turn the picker. There's another 18,778, and we're up to 183 grand. So the Deutz is parked up for now. I don't think we'll do any more silage selling until the new year. We're doing a lot of it. But the thing is, I do it regularly, but we just do a couple of loads. Perhaps I'll just have maybe a day where I do a lot of it and get it out of my system. we'll just take this. We've got 3,500 litres of stones in the back here, so that's probably about 700 quid. So that's not bad. It doesn't cover the cost of leasing the equipment, and it turns out we didn't need it because we didn't need to lime. Nonetheless, it's done. It's a job done. Now, I have had a little look, because I'm thinking about things to do for this afternoon. And one of the wood sale points, one of the purchase, I think it was the biomass heating, is buying wood at the minute for over 3,000 per 1,000 litres, however that works that out at. So, this afternoon's job, since this morning is coming to an end, it's going to be chopping up the wood we've got stored in our little storage section. We'll cut that up and put that on the back of our long-term leased log trailer, and we'll get that sold and we'll see what we can get for that, because the rest of the wood we didn't get a very good price for. So hopefully this will work out a bit more beneficial, and it's the straight really long spruces that we've got. It's not the odd higgledy-piggledy oaks or anything like that. So it should be some good wood, some good weight. That's what I'm hoping. Always trying to make that money. Maybe, would it get us 17 grand? I don't know. Could we peak at 200 grand for end of year? But the only time we've been close to that sort of money is when we got our New Year's inheritance a few years ago. It's crazy how that goes by. But that helped us out a lot. The last couple of days, other than sort of stacking bales, the Massey hasn't really had a job. So I'm wondering if now we're too big for it as a farm. Very little equipment goes on it. Whether it's time to maybe trade that in for another medium tractor in the range of the John Deere and the Deutz, or maybe even a little bit bigger. Just so we've got three really functioning tractors on the farm. Because I can do bales with the wheel loader. I can put a bale spike on that, and we can do that. That's not a problem. So the Massey might be coming to its end days. Let's just get this returned. I know I can just go into the menu and do this, but I like to do it this way. Even the bits where I can edit it out, it's done this way. Let's find our trigger, there it is, and return. Took a bit of paint off it. I've had it for a whole month. Okay, and it's only just over an hour. I was going to say only just over an hour, but it's an hour and a half on there. Okay, returned. So we'll head back to the farm and we'll look into this wood situation. Right, pretty much all set up here. That's all we needed to do, bring that rail to be set up. Now, I have had a little size comparison, and to best fit the trailer, our logs want to be roughly two fence posts long. Unfortunately, they're not all the same spot. I'm sure we can make the most of that. Bring me a chainsaw back out. What's going on here? Right. So, if we were to say... that one there. This one here. That one's further up. Crouch. Beat your crouch. Right, that one's way up, so we come on here. Don't think I can get to the one underneath, but I can. That gimme. Oh, well. Okay. to try and get these loaded on. Now, I should imagine they're going to say they're too heavy, but we're going to do that because they're not that big. I reckon I could lift that easily. Get them on there. Now, I should imagine this will take up much of our daylight now. This tree business is often quite time consuming. And our little trailer is just that, quite small, so we're going to have to do a few trips. The biomass is round the back of the store where we just went and sold our stone, so it's not a long drive. I can't think when we went last time. Oh, it was at the sawmill, weren't it? And that was quite a drive. We haven't got to do the long trip every time. Should come on this side. That'll still squeeze in there. Yeah, look at that. Perfect. Got room around the other side for... Nope, that's on. Wait, I think we can still get two on there quite comfortably. So... do our measurement again. About two posts down. And that was pretty good marking, I think. Using the posts for our measurement. Turn that out there. This one's the long one that's on the top. Lovely job. So, oh, wrap the trailer a little bit. Let's go back inside. I think when we're just walking around and doing things out of cab is still the most when, or still the point when I miss controller the most. I try to do as much as I can now, keyboard and mouse. I mean, farming is always, but I mean generally with other games as well on PC. Is that on or is that just floating? Let's see what I mean. So let's try and get some straps on. It's good, it's good. I think we can get some more on the top there. We can do this. So, oh, two trips, that'd be pretty epic. Right. It's a bit smaller. And since I'm showing you all of this one, the next one, I'll be kind and I'll just show you probably the delivery of it. It's not the most exciting thing, but it is something different. We're not just out playing in the muck and doing needless things, maybe. Or maybe this is the needless thing and you'd rather we were out doing a contract. Guys will have to give me some feedback. Let me know what you think. While you're at it, put a fat thumbs up and hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. If you've stayed here this long, you're clearly interested in something we're doing. There we are. I think that'll be absolutely perfect. That's not all going to go on in the next load, I don't think, although it is the thinner ends. If we stack it top and tail, it might work. But we shall head out to the biomass. Or the biomass heat? Yeah, biomass. I'd think about it for a little minute. Our meadows are going to look pretty... pretty shitty until the new year. Never mind. So we just go around the back. We have been before. Some while back now, or it feels like a while back anyway. I think it was last year. So we've got this full cycle of growth and what have you going on now. Just hold on. Take our straps off. Our trigger should be here. Somewhere. There we go. 6 grand. That's not bad. Now, if we get another 6 grand, which we should be able to, that's 12. We're going to be looking pretty tasty come the end of the day. So what I'll do, I'll head back and I'll get this loaded up again. We'll have another sale, see what sort of money we're making. Well, got it all on. Does it look the best? Possibly not. But it's on. It's worth the same nonetheless. I think two straps will be fine. To be fair, one strap is fine. You just get in the habit of putting them all on. So we'll get this down and sold. Now, I don't think this is going to be worth as much. You can tell there's, obviously, there's not as much wood there. Some of the lengths are longer, but they're not as thick, they're not as dense. When I moved them, I took all the dead ends off, so there's nothing on there that's not of value. There's just not a lot of value to it. And I've only just noticed it stopped snowing. So that's nice. A nice crisp winter's afternoon into a winter's eve. I've said it before, I think this game and this map looks absolutely beautiful in the dull light. When I was doing the finishing off the ploughing and it was sort of late afternoon, it just looked so good. The textures looked so good as well. It really did look quite realistic, especially with the parallaxic texture 3D thing going on with the stones and the furrows, which is something really nice. This extra money as well is going to be really nice. I'm so torn on things I want to do with it as well. Like, we haven't even got it all yet, and I want to do buy land. I want to get the big greenhouse thing set up, which is going to be super expensive. The bit of land is going to cost us 100 grand easily. And I think just the standard large greenhouses, they're 10 grand a piece. I really do think the Massey needs an upgrade. Whether I go for something of a newer kind or something old or oldish like the Deutz and the John Deere, I'm not sure. Money, money, money. That's what it's all about. Them off. Let's stand on the spot. Look at it go. 4 grand. So we got 11 in total for that. So it's 196. So now, do we sell the honey and... Let's turn around the other way. The honey and the eggs. I mean, we've not... I think we've only got half a pallet of eggs, excuse me. But there is 5 times, so we've got like two pallets of eggs, the equivalent of, which always sell good. But I think I should wait till I've got more eggs, more honey. Give it a good year. It's not had a year yet, it's only like 6 months, and then they are filling up, so give it a little bit longer. So I'll just park this up in here for now. Not quite sure when the next lot of let's call it forestry in quotation marks, and the next lot of forestry is going to happen, but we are going to keep it. It's like I say, long-term lease. It's one of the things we're just going to have for life. I was considering picking the Amazon up and selling that, but with all the grass planting we're going to have to do, I might want a worker helping me out so we can both be doing it. Could even have it so I go round, do a couple of headlands, and then while they're going across the field, and we can work one field at the same time, or have the worker set up in those meadows, since they don't need the... does this cultivate? I don't think it does. I'll have to look into it. I don't think that does. So yeah, I may need to do some different things. But anyway, I'm going to keep it for now, just in case I want to stick a worker in it. I'm just going to get that seeded. I want to get that rolled straight after. A lot to do. yeah, with that, I think that's going to be the end of today's episode. We've done a few different things. We've done some things we didn't need to do, but I really thought that the overview map was telling me that we needed to buy or do some lime. As you see, this is a honey. Now, this morning, this only had two boxes on it. It's now got five. Pretty much doing a pallet a day, or a pallet for 2 weeks, as it is in-game. Yeah, 2,000 litres, 2,000 litres, 2,000 litres. It's nice. Then our eggs are here, which is something like 3,135 eggs. 687 kilos. But the value that you sell it at is always like 1,000 litres, so I don't know what that is, sort of literage-wise. I think once you get it on the back of a trailer and strap it down, it tells you in litres. But until that point, I don't know how many litres we have. Just feed our dog again. It's been alright, haven't been no trouble. So yeah, that's the end of today's episode. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. If you have, give it a big fat thumbs up down below. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button, turn your bell notification on, find out when new videos are going live. And as always, comments and feedback down there. You guys have yourselves a wonderful day, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.